Hello everybody, Arkin over here, getting back some more Let's Play Trails to Azure. So, there's nothing new here. I don't know where it's... Oh no, it won't... Yeah, okay, I know where it's... The finalist of the Azure Tree. Kia and the entire truth are waiting for us there. Are we prepared? We are. Red Constellation Warship, Beowulf. Confirmed sighting at 5 o'clock. It's Red Constellation's Beowulf. So they showed up. Red Constellation's Warship, huh? Yeah, they've been talking about buying a warship all the way back when I was still there, but I don't believe it. They already got their hands on one? The Croy clan may have provided them with the current funds for the current plan. It appears they're also using some of the society's technologies. Abbas, can you shake it off? I'll do what I can. Well, it's not only huge, but it's rugged too. We won't lose to it in speed, right? Those are... No way, they scattered electromagnetic mines in the sky? No doubt, those are in use at the Foundation as well. They're no strangers to combat, as expected. Ugh, now they've done it. They've circled around to starboard bow. Abbas, deploy the anti-shock field. Roger. All crew, get down and brace for impact. It's alright, minor damage. Alright, focus the anti-shock field on the nose. Let's head to the huge tree by forcing our way through the minefield, just like this. Roger! It all comes down to this, the culmination of everything we've worked for, everybody we've helped, and the city-state we love. We do this for the special support section, for Kia, for Crossbell, and to prove that we can be just as good as our brother. This is it. They know their shit. And we were planning to catch them with the anchor and take it to hand-to-hand combat. It just means that our proficiency at air battles is still lacking. Well, we should just leave the rest of Master Sigmund and the young lady. I envy them, Mrs. and the Vice Leader. They get to fight to their heart's content in that amazing-looking place. Holy shit. Where are we? Are we really inside the huge tree? The tree was huge for sure, but not this much, right? Has space itself been distorted?
Watashi wo mitsukete.
Indeed. It's so pretty. Could it be a different tree than the one that was outside? Infinite lights are being absorbed by the tree. How to say this? It looks like the basic plan for the orbital net. Even so, it's a great time to take pictures. From here onward, the Merkaba can't proceed because of the gravitational distortion. The only way to proceed is on foot. Oh man, what a pain. Well, if we need to go outside, it appears we can withdraw on the Merkaba. So if push comes to shove, I think we can leave this huge tree. I see. Got it. Anyhow, we need to decide on an exploration unit and a standby one. We don't have time for leisurely sightseeing. Let's get moving at once, Bannings. Yes, sir. Kia should be somewhere inside this huge tree. I will find her at all costs. Alright, and our exploration begins. What the hell is this enemy? Oh, I would have thought that enemy snowflake thing would reflect this wolf. That does not appear to be the case. Give me the old stomping, though. Give me the old stomping. Avoids damage output. Ah, okay, so those crystals just make more pathway. A lot of weird looking foes here. Oh. Well then, that's what they do. Okay. Interesting. They vanish insta-kill. Don't do it! Oh, he did it. I wish he wouldn't have, though. But he did. Everybody's been to die. I keep spamming burning heart. I don't think I'll ever go into the paint animation. Never mind. Just shut me up real quick. Freaking silence me quick. Ambush formation change. Okay. Oh, okay, that was competitive arts. Okay. Freaking Tio can't hit him. These are things we are learning. Things that are... This is information that is valuable. Oh. Another self-existent information. They annihilate if they touch the server. Rune of Affection. Activate or recover 50% HP, all damage received is reduced by half. Okay, so the rune card on the right shows what I needed to show. The buff timer.
Thank you.
I should probably heal, but I'm not going to. Then I'll regret it. I mean, it. Regretting it immediately. Lord is strong as hell right now. I hope the inner area isn't as annoying, or is not annoying. Oh, that sucks. Oh, that really sucks, actually. Damn it. His speed might be down, but his power is still very up. Oh crap! Well then. Damn it. I didn't know there was one of those bastards back there. Ah, they got me. A good amount of TP back. We're in a good spot. I'm getting a whole lot of CP as well. Let me attack this guy. So Teal can actually get some damage in. Oh. Oh, garbage. Oh, no. Still got it. Not garbage. Oh, we level up again. Fantastic. I don't want to go down there yet. Let's go this way. I know I could be using crafts to deal more damage, but I don't know. I'm always just freaking. Anytime I've played these games, I've always just used basic attacks, unless it's a boss fight, because of how the CP mechanic works, or unless I absolutely need freaking do something craftily. Like, if there's a bunch of enemies that I need to take down. I'm just always trying to conserve CP. Because I don't want to be without it if I absolutely need to, like, friggin' S-break a bunch of people or something. That's why I typically try to do random encounters just by spamming basic attacks. And for the most part, it works. Still works. Like, I can spam Ellie's crafts, no problem, because she gets CP back every turn with the equipment. Although, with how the burst mechanic works, I can get my CP back really quickly too. I don't know. It's a little too late to be worrying about that, I guess. Because this is the final dungeon of the final game where I need to, that I'm gonna put on my channel at the moment. I might put Cold Steel 1 through 4 up there at some point. I'd have to buy one or two on the PS4 to record them, because I played them on the Vita. So somewhere down the line, I might put Cold Steel 1, 2, and 3 up here. Let's just bring you up to shoot, girl. What do I get? Bright gem. Does what? Accuracy plus 50. Lame. It does not benefit. God, those guys aren't threatening if I get the first strike on them. Alright, so let's go right this time. Chance did not trigger that time. That's a little unfortunate. Eh, I can always just ask break. Oh, this is bad all around. Oh, I guess maybe not. Well, Lloyd's not gonna get anything out of that. Eh, it wasn't too terrible much, but it would've been nice. Khaled Bulb. Well, that would be nice if I was actually using it. Well, but since I'm not using it well, it's not that helpful. Damn. Oh, come on. Friggin' homeboy must have superhuman hearing or some shit. Ellie already got most of her CP back there. Dang, not how I wanted to have that happen, but that's fine. Lloyd's gonna get the crit, and Teal's gonna get the kill. The finishing blow, not the finishing kill. We'll be right back. powered by something like a barrier. It's probably kind of magical barrier, but setting aside the central part, I wonder what those things on the left and right sides of it are. Those are known as territories. Belle! Belle! Is that you? Of course, Ellie. Welcome to the Azure Tree. Kaya will be glad that you have come as well. No. Rather, she will be sad, perhaps? Belle, you... Putting aside your goals, it seems you have no intention of stopping us at all, right? Correct. This sanctuary is Kaya's very own interior. Her desires of wanting you to come and not wanting you to come are reflected here, just as they are in her mind. They appear in the form of guardians you see wandering around. So it's because this place is inside her mind that there's so much space, eh? However, this is the last banquet. For much more fun, I prepared different grounds. And they are their gates. Different grounds. Hey now, can you stop playing games with me? It's quite simple. Just as the sanctuary reacts to Kia's inner self, those gates are linked to territories that react to other people's inner selves. Other people? Could you mean? If you have people with a connection to them, well then, everyone. My guidance ends here. I'll be waiting for you at the main grounds. Provided you manage to reach them safely and alive, that is. Belle. Really, this goes beyond a simple joke. However, setting aside the central gate, it seems we can enter the gates on the left and right. The problem is, who is beyond them? Well, for now, let's give them a try. It seems we won't be able to enter unless we have someone related to the person inside. Right. Yes. It's no use, it looks. Even if we were to strike, it wouldn't break. If only we could figure out who's inside. My power is the greatest. Yeah, that's right. Even greater than that bastard's. Honestly, why does he have to be particular about a blockhead like me? Wazzy. Besides, Lloyd, it looks like he wants to sell it to me. I understand. Barrier disappeared. Now we can go to the territory's grounds, huh? Yeah. However, it won't end in a game of fun this time. Shall we make sure we're ready to face him? Might do us good to return to Merkaba. Yeah, it might. Territory of Shup. This place is a territory. A vast wasteland. Just like that guy's personality, huh? Those things look like some kind of negative energy. Oh man, I seem to have underestimated him just a tiny bit. Who could have thought some street fighter could transform this much? Wazzy, let's go. Waldo's waiting for me up ahead, and this time I'll have to beat him down with everything I've got. Done? I think you're done. Oh, they actually hit her. Shocking. And altogether a little annoying. Oh, big experience is happening again. Okay. Grants debt to those who are. That's fine, I didn't want to cast anything anyway. Shitty-ass. Okay, so that's EP draining. Well, thankfully I don't really use EP all that much for anything. And if I do need EP for something, well, Tio has its ability to just recover it at that point. Eight. dynamic. Or rain too. What does that even mean? Oh. And defense up, huh? Got him. Yeah. Yada yada yada. Okay, it's continuing to keep them up and up. And if I end it, Okay. So I can just have Teo just give us a bunch of freaking turns of good stuff. Freaking just by feeding her EP bombs and crap. So I understand how they work now. And yes, they are incredibly powerful. You can't hurt me. Neat, but completely irrelevant at this point in the game for me. I don't need to use Burning Rage to power up in battle, because I start with 50% extra power. My eggs in one power basket. Alright, that makes sense. That is not leveling up as fast as I was hoping. I want to master that chord. Well, it's still doing stuff. Yeah. Damn. She can just keep that up. I got sick and tired of waiting so damn long, you know? Wald. Ha! You even came all dressed up in your work clothes and everything. The girls are the secret unit of the church, is it? More or less. Although I personally like the style I wore during my time as a testament more. Oh, but even the suit I rock when I'm a host isn't too shabby either, I guess? A bastard with poor taste as always. Messing around with all those side jobs made your head numb, didn't it? You're one to talk. Even though you retained power, you still won't part with that lame excuse for a wooden sword. Why would I? After all, this little guy's my symbol. That I'm not some soulless being living a lie, being used by everyone, like you. And that's why you destroyed the downtown apartment with a kick, right? Even to derail that train, you used all your might to do so. Heh, so you knew. Even if I didn't want to know, it was pretty obvious to begin with. He seemed to be getting along rather well. Right. Well, it looks like an ironically acceptable relationship. Walt, let me confirm one thing. Who gave you that power? No, who gave you the gnosis? Was it Maria Bell? Ah, that blue drug? Oh yeah, I've got a feeling she blurted out a name like that. It wasn't a red-colored one? Yes, it's the red one which causes one to demonize, and yet, how? Heh, according to that woman, it seems I'm a good match, you know? I have the qualities to be able to tap into my maximum power even without using the dangerous one. Well, that was the reasoning behind it, but I don't give a shit either way. This isn't good. Don't tell me Bell gave that drug to someone else as well. Well, it doesn't look that way. Heh, she's a mysterious bitch, but I personally don't dislike that side of her. She's pretty damn devoted to her own ambitions, you know? So you were tempted by her sweet words, and you started desiring unlimited power. Heh, wrong. I've been yearning for power ever since I was a little brat. And after my drunkard of an old man croaked, I was left alone on the streets of downtown. Brawling in the streets, I eventually found my sanctuary in the Viper's Ignis. Even when things heated up after an opponent like you appeared, that desire kept smoldering at the bottom of my heart. Ugh. And that is my thirst for power. Oh, the wind, the demonization. The ogre. Heh, come now. It's your turn to show me your thirst for power. The proof that you and I are the same. Very well. However, mine is not the same as yours. What? This is a golden pattern? Stigma. Because this mark appeared, I obtained everything and lost everything. Family, homeland, future, everything. I live a fabricated life, combining power with continuous despair. That is me, Wazi Hemisphere, you. Dominion number 9, the Azure Testament, Wazi Hemisphere. With this golden colored radiance, I will break your power. Are you prepared? Excellent! By devouring you as a sacrifice, my power will be complete. Come, let's settle this. Eat all of my CP with that? says he just gets this, he just gets instantly bodied. Just so much seepeth. Oh! Wazzy, damn you! What the hell? You should have used up all his physical strength already, and yet. Actually, I should have done this on that rainy day. Going all out, I was too worried about your safety. Huh? However, this time, neither as a crawl sitter nor as a stigma owner. I will show you my greatest attack. As Wazzy Hemisphere, the Testament's leader, just like I did when the first time I met you. Very well, I'll just have to bring you down with me. Ah. Knocked. Oh. Oh. Ah. He did it. Turned to his original form. Thank goodness. I think even the finishing blow was the same as that day. Pathetic. Really? Well, since you were demonized, I guess it means that's your limit. I think your sense to handle power is the real deal. I think that if you had some proper training under your belt, you could become even stronger. You don't have to tell me. I would have improved anyway. To force you down on your hands and knees one day, Wazzy. Still. Just this once, I admit my defeat. Also, hey, you guys. I don't give a damn about what will happen to you, but I'm unable to stomach that brat's gonna be mug. You've got to go all out. Ah, well, that goes without saying. Thank you. Nice work, Wazzy. Good work. I guess I'm really tired. Hey, Wazzy, you okay? When I use the stigma power, there are side effects. Could I really have gone a bit too overboard? I can't blame you against such a giant opponent. Are you alright? Well, somehow or other. See Daisy. With this territory has probably been released. We'll come get Walt later, so let's return to the game for now. Understood. Let's try heading back. Come on, I'll let you my shoulder. Bye, Walt. See ya, loser. The sensor gate's magical barrier has weakened. It's probably because we released Walt's territory effect. I think this sanctuary might be connected with each person's territories. That means if we can release the other territory, then the magical barrier would probably vanish completely. I'll bet it would, but we're gonna call it here for now. Till next time, everybody, this has been Ark Nova playing Trails to Azure. Stay cool.